Thank you. How you doing, Bowling Green? You all right tonight? Because I can't fucking deal with this shit anymore. The club that we're playing at tonight doesn't have any subs, so there's no low end for any of you guys to hear shit, so it's not really set up for a rock concert, but we're playing for you anyways, and we're fucking making it happen. So, there you go. But I had to say that because this isn't our fucking fault. But I love you guys very much. Thank you. I appreciate you coming to the show. Thank you. terrible insane. So how now, just to find you. I'm so sick of this terrible insane. How now, just to find you. Like a poet's dying girl. Like a poet's dying girl. Still remember when she looked at me. Never go away. fucking head or I was scared. Let all the love inside the world belong to you. Well, I can't understand just why you ran away. Too young to feel the pain and bitterness of love. Well, I could never understand a motherfucking word you'd ever say. And all the people that you hurt came down on you. Well, I can't understand just why you went away. Well, I saw the
over, can't explain the way that I feel. Well, I can't. Well, everyone got twisted up. Well, everyone got behind my back and broke it. Curls and spine. Yeah.
Alright, well, now I have a new riser that I can stand on, because this fucking monitor is bullshit. This next song was a song that was written during a gnarly time in my life. I was driving down A1A writing a lot of lyrics back in the day. It was a road through Florida, from New York to Florida. It's along the ocean. I always write lyrics along the ocean. One day there was a gun involved in the beach, and I heard this piano song that came into my head right before I did a bad thing to myself. And it changed the direction of my life, and it created a different kind of pain the whole record.
Clouds to hide my wind.
You know what, Johnny? I can feel the fucking bass when I stand on the speaker. So maybe we should all just flip over our shit and everybody should get on stage. That way they can feel the fucking bass on the show because they don't have any fucking low end at this fucking venue. Love you guys. We're just bitching because we want you guys to have the best show you could possibly have. And I'm really upset about that, them not having what they needed to have tonight. So apologies from us, but it ain't our fucking fault. Love y'all very much. All right, this next song, we never played ever. We did it one time on a late night show. Here's a little story for you, son. So we did it one night on a late night show a long, long time ago. We never played it on tour because I have a problem with when I write songs, I get a little too emotional about them, and there's a certain amount of songs that I can play during a set without breaking down during the set. And doing that every night is a hard fucking thing to do if you have a certain amount of songs where you just lose your shit every night. It's not healthy for you mentally or physically or any of the things. Well, it is for you, but for me, it's a fucking brutal thing to go through every night. I feel you, man, and I love you for that. So, here we go. I'm playing a song for you, sir. All right. You guys sing along with me, though, because I probably can't get through the whole thing.
Was to not betray. For the shame that I'm in, it's a heart to fail.
Fucking love you guys so much, man. Thank you. All the beautiful people, man. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. All right, this next song, we're going to bring on a friend of ours, Ed Kuzo from University Drive. Ed, sorry for the monitor that's turned over on the stage. I just had to do it because it was yelling at me the whole fucking time. And I couldn't take it. I know you know how that is, man. I know it's a brutal thing. It was screaming at me. I fucking kicked her over. And now I'm standing on it like this. This is what I do. If you guys are musicians and you know when a monitor is screaming at you, you need to kick that motherfucker over. Just stand on it. Fucking get mad at people. Love you guys. This next song was a song that was written years ago. I had the music for it. It sounded a little different than Cold. And we were in California, and I went out to eat dinner with Rivers from Weezer, and he's a good friend of mine. He was the most amazing man. I was a huge Weezer fan, by the way. I started out when I was like 19. When I saw the Buddy Holly video, I got the fucking lightning bolt guitar strap. I was all like, fuck yeah. Not only that, their guitar sound was the dopest guitar sound you could ever have in your life. Like, when that shit kicked in heavy, Weezer was fucking up everybody. So, right, Ed?
It's the truth.
It's the truth. So, you know, so when we were doing this song, I was like, holy shit, I'm sitting with Rivers. I got the song. I go, would you maybe help me write some lyrics to it? And he helped me write it. And it became one of the biggest songs for Cold. I have a love-hate relationship with this song because... maybe because I didn't write it. It's not as sad as the most songs that we did with Cold. However, I appreciate what he did for us, man. He's one of my favorite fucking people in the world, and I love him very much. So we're going to do this song for you guys tonight. Enjoy it. And have fun.
Oh,
Piper Ave, University Drive. Good stories, my friend.
There's some young kids in here that might know your voice. Hold on.
KK! What are you doing?
KK! All right, so years ago, you better hear the story now or you want to talk some shit? Years ago, back when I was in high school, I quit high school because I wanted to be a musician, which kind of worked out. I quit high school. I had worked at Holiday Inn trying to make ends meet. I was 17 years old. I worked so much that they gave me a fucking room there because that's all I wanted to do was just make money and buy instruments and do shit for music. So when I did, my friends from high school and from me growing up, Jack and Becky, lived across the street. We lived on the beach. Holiday Inn was on the ocean. They were across from First Street. I woke up one morning at 3 a.m., went out to have a cigarette on the balcony. When I did, the house is on fire. They don't know if it was still granted we partied there a lot and stuff like that, but they don't know if it was an electrical thing or somebody just fell asleep, fucked up, smoking a cigarette. But it was a brutal thing, and it rains all the time in Jacksonville, Florida. So the only thing I wanted it to do was pour down rain. I saw the fire going, and it was too far gone. The house was burned, and it was going in flames. So all I wanted to do was have the rain come down and wash it away. So this song is inspired by that. It's a hard fucking song for me to get through. Again, like all cold songs, mostly. So you guys help me out if I can't fucking finish this one either. All right, you ready?
Every child.
Yeah.
Hey, Bowling Green, thank you very much for tonight. We appreciate you. All right, well, we got two more songs for you. This next song was a song that, since I'm in storyteller mode, the next song was a song that we wrote during the Things We Can't Stop. And we had the music for it. It was beautiful music. Then it comes to me, you know, sometimes I'll write the music and I don't know what the fuck to sing to it. And it just comes to me one day or one moment, or I see a photo or a movie or something like that happens. Our good friend Matthew Kaiser, he was a Cold Army fan a long time ago, and he became one of my best friends, and he still is to this day. We talk every day. His father passed away while we were doing the record, and just so happens his father lived in Phoenix, Arizona. So when his father died, he had to fly to Phoenix to be at the funeral, and we were creating the record there. So I go, well, let's have him over. The Super Bowl was going on. I thought we could cheer him up a little bit and, you know, maybe make him feel better. And I think we did. However, he showed me a picture that a friend of mine had took. Dave Jackson had edited a photo of a friend of his that took a photo of him and his father just holding hands. And when I saw him and his father holding hands, it was just a picture of two hands together. I go, oh, there's quiet now. It all came to me right there, because I'll tell you what, the most deafening silence that you could ever hear is when someone passes away from you, when you don't hear their fucking, you don't hear the you don't hear them in the kitchen anymore. You know, you don't hear them walking down the hall. You don't hear the footsteps. You don't hear the silence, the little things that they do. So it's deafening when you fucking, that's what quiet now is about. Right? So you need to hear those sounds. And sometimes those sounds will haunt you for a long time after somebody passes. But when you don't hear them anymore, it's the worst thing you can ever hear. That's what crying out's about. So here you go, Matthew.
It's a little too quiet now.
You guys be safe getting home tonight, all right? We got a loud song. Everybody join in. It's not as sad as the other ones. So, thank you, but welcome to a fucking cold show. That's what we do. All right? All right, let's get it.
Lost, gone.